Again and again, the celebrations went on. It started the night of February 12th, a week ago Tuesday. The empty net with Jim Craig, the United States goaltender, having been pulled to get the extra attacker up front. The U.S. against Sweden. The Swedes to go on to the bronze medal. The score at that point, 2-1 Sweden. The concerned look on the face of U.S. head coach Herb Brooks. The United States trailing 2-1, the final seconds. Now Harrington goes out, Pavlich comes in, slap shot by Ramsey is blocked in front. Baker, number six, to Schneider, Buzz, back of the net, fighting for control of the puck with 29 seconds to play. Baker on it! Joel Baker with 27 seconds remaining in the game, and look at that scene on the ice. The Americans tie the Swedes. Baker from out in front, beating Lindbergh to tie it 2-2.
My goal against Sweden, I hope, gave us a little momentum to go into the Czechoslovakian game with a little more confidence as a team that we could, you know, play with them and, you know, get two more points and give us the ability to, you know, get right up with the front runners in the tournament. I think it might have given us that confidence, and if it did, you know, I'm just happy that I could have contributed that way.
Baker's goal made the final score, the U.S. 2, Sweden 2. 48 hours later, the key matchup with Czechoslovakia. Second period action here. The score at this point, the U.S. 2, Czechoslovakia 2. Here comes Pavlich, who set up the goal by Baker the other night with a great pass. Pavlich, number 16, tries to back.
We tied Sweden, we thought they were probably the second best team in the world, and I think that gave us confidence, and it carried us over into the Czechoslovakia game. And if we thought if we could stay with them and stay within our system, the third period, if we could have at least be tied, we'd have a chance to beat them.
The U.S. had the lead 4-2 going into the third period, and it was Buzz Schneider to score again, the only veteran of the 1976 U.S. Olympic team. The final score, the USA 7 and Czechoslovakia 3. There was the obvious emotional letdown 2 days later as the USA took on Norway. And after the first period, Norway led the Americans 1-0.
After the first period, we sat down in the locker room and we're looking at each other and say, hey, you know, if we're going to win this game, we got to rely on hard work. That's because that's the way we got here. So I think we, after the first period, realized that if we worked hard and we played our style and played our system, that, you know, we can win that game.
The Americans settled down, and when it was over on Saturday, the Americans had another victory. They were 2-0-1 as they beat the Norwegians 5-1. Next up was Romania, an obviously inferior team on Monday night. The Americans, though, skated well and added another win to make it 3-0-1, winning 7-2. The Americans went into the game with West Germany on Wednesday night, already having clinched a medal round berth because of Sweden's win over Czechoslovakia earlier that day. The Americans won anyway, defeating the West Germans 4-2. The medal round began on Friday night. The Americans and the Soviet Union. The matchup, the goalies, Jim Craig for the U.S., Vladislav Tretiak for the Soviet Union.
The biggest fear I think we had in the Russian game was to be in awe of them and go out there and thinking that, you know, they beat the NHL All-Stars, the best in the world, and that if we did that, we wouldn't play up to our ability.
Craig made 16 saves in the first period Friday night, but still, the Americans trailed the Soviets 2-1 as time began to expire in the first period. Long shot, the easy save by Tretiak, but Johnson is there and scores with 1 second to play in the period. The U.S. tying the Soviets 2-2 for the first time in the tournament, a smile creasing the face of head coach Herb Brooks. The Soviets, however, led 3-2 after the second. The Americans tied the game on Mark Johnson's goal in the third. This action midway through the third period. Buzz, long slap shot, saved by Mushkin.
The U.S. team is depending a little bit too much now on Jim Craig. He's making too many good saves.
Arruzioni scores! Mike Arruzioni! The Americans led 4-3. And the creased smile of Herb Brooks became a wide grin. But there were still 10 minutes to play. The Soviets kept the pressure on. The Americans still leading 4-3. The final half minute of play. 28 seconds. The crowd going insane. Karlamov shooting it into the American end again. Morrow is back there. Now Johnson, 19 seconds. Johnson over to Ramsey. Vigiletinov gets checked by Ramsey. McClanahan is there. The puck is still loose. 11 seconds. You've got 10 seconds. The countdown going on right now. Morrow up to Schultz. 5 seconds left in the game.
Over.
You believe in miracles? Yes!
Unbelievable.
The Americans had done the seemingly impossible. They had upset the Soviets 4-3, but still to come was Finland for the gold medal.
Now for an extra special winter event, the Owens Corning Fiberglass Save Twice Insulation Sale. Number one, save on pink Owens Corning Fiberglass insulation now. It's on sale. Number two, save on...
For the approximately 10,000 people who packed the Olympic Center this morning, it was breakfast and then out to the hockey game. Vice President Mondale was there, and the situation was simple as the captains exchanged gifts before the game. For the Americans, win the game and take home the gold medal. But it looked like the same script again, because Finland had the lead after the first period, 1-0, thanks mainly to the efforts of number 19, the goaltender Jorma Valtonen. With saves like those, the Finns led, but the Americans were able to tie the game in the second period on a goal by Steve Kristoff. With a score of 1-1, action here now midway through the second period, and the Finns take the lead again on a goal by number 15, Mikko Leinonen. The Finns had the lead 2-1, and the American mood at that point reflected in that profile shot of Buzz Schneider, number 25. The third period began with a score, Finland 2 and the United States 1, as Davy Christian skated over the blue line. Then the goal that tied the game by Phil Vrkota. It came at the 2:25 mark, and the Americans were even. 3.5 minutes later, the U.S. attacking again. Mark Johnson with the puck. Back of the net, number 10, out to Rob McClanahan, 24. He stuffs it in, and the Americans had the lead 3-2. But there was an intensely anxious moment to come. With only 4 minutes and 15 seconds remaining in the game, the Czechoslovakian referee Schubert sent Bill Vrkota to the penalty box, 2 minutes for roughing. And the Finns had a power play opportunity, a chance to tie the game. The Americans leading 3-2. Back to center ice. Morrow has it. 1:33 left in the penalty.
Kristoff and Broughton doing a great job of forechecking, and Kristoff's shot went off the post.
Kristoff scrapping for it again. Gets it out in front, but the Americans control, keeping it in. Johnson skating in the shot. The reach, and he scores! The shorthanded goal made it the U.S. 4, Finland 2. And then the countdown began. The crowd going insane at the moment. Bedlam in here, stomping. 5 seconds to the gold medal, 4 to the gold medal. This impossible dream comes true.
And so the American hockey team has accomplished what neither Rune Arledge nor any of our producers, Al, have ever been able to accomplish. To get me to say on the air, I can't think of anything to say, and then you guys did the same deal.
There was nothing.
You couldn't, could you?
No, you can't. I mean, you just, as I said, you want to savor the moment. The thing of it is also, I think a lot of people feel that it's almost been a surrealistic sort of situation. I think Tuesday's going to come along, and everybody's going to want to go to another hockey
That's
game.
Right.
You just want it to go on and on and on and on.
I know. I said to my wife this morning before I left the hotel, I said, this will be a first for you, turning on your television set at 11 o'clock on Sunday morning. And she said, and to watch a hockey game. Look, that award ceremony you mentioned a little while ago, we said that we had on tape here. We're going to take a look at that right now, because what a moving moment that was. Following the Soviet-Sweden silver medal game, the ceremony honoring the USA team. Jimmy Craig.
It was that unrestrained league. There was one confining factor here today, Jim, that they were on the ice. I think everybody wanted to jump up or dance or whatever, but they were on the ice, so they were slipping around. It was almost as if they were unfortunately stationed in one position.
Take the skates away from them. They're helpless on ice.
Oh, yeah. It's something else for them on.
Thank you, Sharon. Well, didn't want to go home, did they, Al? They just didn't want to leave.
That man right there, I think, symbolizing this entire hockey team. The team captain, 25 years old.
Michael Lucioni. And he called his guys back up there. He didn't want to be there by himself.
You know, I think the people could have remained in that arena, Jim, until now.
They were so happy, and they wanted to demonstrate their joy, but they had no idea how to do it. They ran out of ways. Still they stayed around, and still the fans stayed around.
Mike again. That chant is going on, I dare say, in many places around Lake Placid still tonight, and will. When they brought out the nation's flag. And then, at last, they picked up the chant that had been for them. Because it was all about the USA, as well as about the young men from the colleges of the United States and from the minor leagues of hockey who had done what had been thought impossible. Ken, I compared it the other night to a bunch of Canadian college football players beating the Pittsburgh Steelers. Is that close?
Well, I suppose it is.